it's Liz Yuille from Old Stables Crafts, UK independent Stampin Up demonstrator. Thank you for joining me again today. Today I have a sneak peek, and we all like sneak peeks. So this is another of the items that I am using for the craft store that I'm having at a local school fair. So I am using the Lilypad Lake bundle. The Lilypad Lake bundle is obviously the stamp set, which I've got in clear mount. It is available in wood mount as well. And the framelit dies. I will show you the dies because otherwise it's just a packet. So these are the dies. So we have got dies to cut these boats, and they cut in one pass. A die to cut the sun, which could also be the moon. One to cut the lily pad. One to cut the crane, and then some labels and waves. The waves do not cut the wave stamp, but they can cut paper to make waves. There is also this fern or plant, so that's an additional die cut that isn't in the stamp set. So I'm actually only going to use this stamp today. The rest I'm doing with die cuts, which I have already cut, and I've cut the plant and the crane, and I've just cut those in basic black cardstock, and I will show you those momentarily. I have got to thank the amazing Jenny Hall, who is a US demonstrator. She recently posted and had a YouTube video about this project, and I am shamelessly copying it because it's stunning, and it will be perfect to fit in this frame, which I bought at a local discount store. You can get similar frames from IKEA, but this was from a local discount store. It's got a bit of fluff in it, so it's a 5x6 frame, so I'm using 5x6 as my base, but I'm keeping the mount, because someone's cut a mount, I'm gonna keep it. So I'll pop that down for the moment, but it does mean that I have therefore cut a piece of glossy white cardstock to 5x6. I am going to use a piece of scrap paper just to cover my work surface, because we are going to be brayering. The first thing I'm going to do, however, is using Versamark ink, I'm going to ink up the wave stamp, and I am going to now let's grab the mount, because I want you to see that I'm not actually making a boo-boo here. So I've cut this at 5x7. This stamp is wider than the mount, so I'm not worried that so long as I go down the middle of the card, it's going to be fine. So, having said that, I am going to start off the bottom, or off the where the bottom will be as far as the mount is concerned. So, and obviously it's Versamark, you're not going to be able to see it, but it's a great technique, and I've forgotten all about it. So thank you, Jenny, for reminding me. We think it's called ghosting, but Versamark is a watermark ink. We use it for embossing powder because it is a very sticky ink, but it's a watermark ink, so its main property is that it creates a watermark, and that is what we are going to be using it. It's that property that we're going to be using. So I've not done a brilliant job of that, in that there is a gap between the three lots of stamping, but I'm not going to stress about it. It will be fine. So I've done that three times. Now I am just going to grab my trusty cheese board and clip this to that, because I need to dry the Versamark. It is really important that it is not still tacky. Oops, I just want to protect my paper. So grab my heat tool. Sorry about the noise. I'm going to have it on the low setting. If you've ever wondered what the low setting is for, drying ink is a good reason to have the low setting. Now, I will be using all bar one of the new ink colours from the 20, these are going to be the 2018-2020 ink colours. The one I'm not using is the Call Me Clover, because it's not really that sort of project, but I am using all the others. I will be adding in some Pool Party, not a huge amount, just a bit, but that's probably there or thereabouts, because I will be starting at the top and working down. So, don't need those bits, don't need that. Turn it over. So I'm going to use my silicone mat to, in inverted commas, mix the ink. I'm going to start with the Pineapple Punch. And as I say, this is a real thank you to Jenny for this project, because she thought it up and it's stunning. So, Brea, this is stained clean dirt, not dirty. So I'm going to pick up my ink from the silicone mat. I'm just going to turn that a little bit and then just roll it across my gloss card. And it's just to get that sort of lovely soft background, and it will all become apparent. I will be linking to the post that Jenny did about her version of this, her original. So fear not as far as that is concerned. I do like to give credit where it is due. Jenny has some stunning, stunning projects. Now, and on the subject of, she does say that when your sponge starts to leave bits of sponge, that's probably the moment to think about changing your sprayer, the sponge bit. Mine is beginning to do that. It's not too bad yet, but I think I will probably be doing that. I've had these for a while now, and I use them in class, so it doesn't surprise me. Right, Grapefruit Grove, which is this lovely pink grapefruit colour, and it's definitely a pink grapefruit. I may just, let me grab some paper towel and just create a bit of a space. I don't want to infect it too much. So just add a bit of that to my silicone mat. And then, oops, don't really want sticky fingerprints all over the place. Probably going to need some more of that. But for the moment, it's doing nicely. So this is one of those projects that takes time, but is not difficult. Do like the new opening. It's so much quicker, and once you've opened your ink pad a few times, it's just so easy to do. It does take a bit of getting used to. I have to say that I have tried to do the push bit, and then with some of the old style ink pads that I've got, I've tried to do the just flip, and it does take a little bit of getting used to. But it's fine. So we're doing a good job of building up this colour. So I now need to add just a little bit of lovely lipstick. I don't want to go mad with this. It is a strong colour. So just a bit. I haven't used this one as much as the others, so it's not quite as easy to open and close as the others yet, and then just be a little bit circumspect about adding it, but probably got a little bit too much there, but we can get rid of some of that and then pick up some more of our softer colours. And then the key is to keep going over and over, and you can see already where the stamping is. So it is doing that ghosting resist. In with my paper towel, I can polish that a bit, which helps smooth some of the ink out. Probably want to get a bit more grapefruit grove on there. Pop some at the top. Pick that up and just soften that pink down a bit. There we go. But isn't that a lovely sunset? Because that's what we're aiming for. We're going for that sunset look. I do want to go a little bit into the water, and then I'm going to actually probably need to get a damp cloth or a wet wipe. Just going to clean that off, and I'm going to do it deliberately over the silicone mat so that I'm also clearing some of the ink off the silicone mat as we go. But yeah, we'll just grab a wet wipe. Clean that off. Because it's the silicone mat, it cleans up really easily. And then just grab a piece of kitchen paper and get the last bits off. This is washable, the silicone mat, just run it under a tap and everything just comes off. It's beautiful. Right, so just make sure that we've got the worst of the pink off the roller, which we have. Don't mind a bit of it because we want that smoothness. Some pool party, and just add quite a bit of that to our silicone mat. Just so that we've got something in the background. What are we doing for time? Good grief, I've been at this for 13 minutes. You must be bored out of your brains. Okay, let's see if I can speed this up because I don't like doing fast forward. It does mean that I do take time to do these things. I do apologise, but you get it as it is. Right. Do want some more of that blue. Don't need a huge amount more, but I do need a bit. So do remember that when this is available for you to purchase, which will be from the 1st of June, you can get 10% off if you hop over to my online store and buy it as a bundle. Now, because it's not yet available, I won't be able to link it as such because it's not available. polish this away. And I just want to add a bit more of that grapefruit grove, which just softens everything down. And then we're going to be very close to finished. You will be delighted to know, because we're now at 15 and a half minutes. And this really is watching paint dry. Okay, let's call that done. Now, to clean that and this, all I need to do is run it under a cold tap. You can have it warm, but I would say not hot. And I'm just going to take my paper towel and polish that so that we've got that whole sheen. But look how that Versamark has resisted. That is just perfect. So, okay, I need my mount because that's going to be key to where I put everything. So the mount goes on, and then in true Blue Peter fashion, here are some that I've prepared earlier. These are the bits that I have already die cut. I'm going to need some mini dimensionals, which, you know, I thought I had in my little trug there, and I haven't. Excuse me. Grab some out of my drawer. They're not even on my desk. Well, they probably are on my desk. They're probably just buried under something. If you could see the state of my desk, it would be a thing to behold. Right, so the first thing I'm going to do is pop some of these on the back of my crane. They are just too large to go behind his head, I think. Maybe not. No, I'm okay. Oh, no, just too large. So let's peel that off. Get rid of that. I will cut one in half. It'll be fine if I can get the one I've just had on my finger off my finger. So let me, whoops. I do like my dingly danglies, but they do sometimes catch on my scissors. So let's pop a half behind his head. And because we've got it anyway, we might as well pop that there just to give it a bit more support. Now, I'm going to do something really cruel and wicked in a minute, and I apologise for any animal lovers, but I'm going to cut his feet off. Because someone made a suggestion, and I think it's right, that if you've got his feet attached, it looks like he's walking on water, whereas if you take his feet off, it doesn't. I'm going to just not have them quite so, come into the light a bit, have them not quite so sharp at the bottom, which I know is kind of counterintuitive if he's not walking on water. That's better. Right, okay, so that's matey. I think I'll put matey down and then we can work round the rest of the picture. So I do find that getting the backs off the mini dimensionals is much easier if you use your piercing tool. So making note of where the frame goes, I'll pop him down there and then grabbing some glue dots. Oh, there's some open. Grabbing my open glue dots. Now the glue dots are slightly too big for the base of these, but you can pop them on and then fold it over. And then I'm actually going to pop that on the frame because then it helps with the whole 3D thing. And then again, half and flip it under, and we'll have one there. Actually, if you put the glue dots slightly higher up, it's almost perfect. One in. Oops. One there, I think, just to cover his leg a wee bit. Now, I've cut 7 of these because I like odd numbers, and therefore 7 seemed like a good place to start. Again, I'm going to pop one on the frame, but obviously you can go with it whatever number you want, but I do like odd numbers, so that would be my suggestion, that you, that really wants to be under there. That's 5. Do I need 2 more? Probably. Pop another one there. And then, oh, just as you do the, oh no, there is another glue dot. I was just about to say my glue dots have run out, but they haven't. Now, where are we on time? Oh, we've actually ended up, for me, not bad. So I'll have that just there. So, that is going to be my framed item, which I think is stunning. And although there's this sort of blue haze here, isn't, I mean, that's just perfect. It gives that almost impression of something in the distance, some land in the distance maybe. But I think that is stunning. I cannot thank Jenny enough for her inspiration. Please, please, please hop over to her website and have a look at her work. It is stunning, and she is the most amazing person. I have worked with her on a couple of occasions on some blog hops, and she is the most gracious person you could wish to meet. So please do spend some time going and having a look at her website. I hope you've enjoyed that. I hope it's given you some ideas of how you can use Versamark in a different way. I think we try and get our, I think we have it in our heads that the only thing it's for is to use with embossing powder. Well, it's not. Here we have the perfect example of why it's not. Anyway, thank you very much indeed for watching. If you don't already subscribe, it's down in the bottom right hand corner. Oh, and while I remember, so I've been whiffling on, as I do, about the Share What You Love bundles that are available at the moment for customers. And the bundles all contain free product, which is great, but if they are not for you, and not everyone likes the Share What You Love bundles, I don't know why, but not everybody does, we are also doing early at 10% off if you buy the whole of the In Colour set. And doesn't that just stack beautifully? If you buy all 5 of the new In Colours in May over at my online store, you will get 10% off. So don't just think it's the Share What You Love that's available earlier. You can get this as well. And remember that during May, I am doing an amazing prize draw. If you spend, well, for every £25 you spend in May at my online store, sorry, there's a bit of fluff, you will be entered, if you use the hostess code, you will be entered to win the Colour Caddy, which is no longer available in the UK. I'm talking about UK market. So the Colour Caddy and all 4 of the 2017-2018 Colour Family ink pads. It is worth well over £200. And one lucky winner, who just for spending their money with me and using the hostess code, will win all of that from me. This is from me. It's my gift to my customers, and it's to try and encourage people to actually use the hostess code, because some people have been shopping with me and not using the hostess code, which means you don't get free product from me, because everyone who uses the hostess code gets free product from me, because I share the host rewards, the stamping rewards, with people who use the host code. So please, 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 if you're shopping with me, use the host code. If you're spending £150 or more, then obviously you become your own host. and that's fine, and you'll still get an entry into the draw, so that's fine. But if you're just shopping small amounts, please use the host code and then you get free product. You do have to spend £25 in order to qualify for that, but it's £25 over the course of the month. So, you know, so if you spend £15 one week and £35 the next week, I'll add those two together. And that means you will get two entries into the draw. It also means, of course, that you will get free product from the host rewards. So, thank you very much indeed for watching. As I say, if you don't already subscribe, please do. It's the bottom right-hand corner. Any questions, comments, please leave a comment below. There is a link to my blog post about this immediately below the in the description bar. There's also a link to my online store. It looks a bit like gibberish. It's a Linktree link, which if you click on that, it's the only other link below, it will take you to all my social media links, which includes my store. As I say, over on my blog post, there will be a link through to Jenny's blog about this particular project that she did, because I obviously want to show my gratitude. So thank you very much indeed for watching, and I will see you again very soon, I hope. Bye!